guys, so today I'm going to be showing you the tutorial for the heart tie-dye max. Anyway, so I'm going to do two, since sometimes, like, one of them fails, at least one of them succeeds. So these are the two color combos I'm going to be using for these two masks. You will need some rubber bands, two masks, one at least, and then some tie-dye. And then, so first, you're gonna get your heart shape cut out, half cut out, and then you're gonna fold your mask, kind of like this, and then you're gonna put it like this, like that. And you're going to trace it with a marker or a pen or anything, really, like a Sharpie or something. And then you're going to put it like this, and then you're going to write on it. This won't be too hard, because then if you tie-dye it, then it's going to be bad. And then you're going to see it. Like that. Then I'm going to do the same thing with my other mask. And then the next step, you take this out. And then you're going to try to fold it. Hold on, let me take my gloves off because it's kind of hard to fold it with gloves on. I'm going to fold it like this. Kind of grab it. And try to make a straight line. I just like follow the line and kind of like that. And then you're gonna tie the line. It won't be perfect when I tie it, but I'll fix it. And get it like that. And put that aside, and then I'm gonna do this one. I do it like that. And just tie it. Like that. Like these two, like little octopuses. And then this is where you start tie-dyeing. So let me put back my gloves on. I like to tie it so none of the tie-dye gets in my hands. Alright, there's a hole in this one. So I'm gonna use my other one. This one's a little bit dirty. But it's fine. Like that, and then I'm gonna do this one. Alright. So I like to use the lighter colors in the middle and then the darker colors on the outside. And then to press on it. Alright. And then kind of be careful with the lines. Yeah, it's gonna. And I simply just. For the strings, I kind of clump my feet, clump them together, and then squirt it, squeeze it in my hands, so the strings are fully purple. And then, if it didn't go all the way, sometimes I just like, rip off and just do like this. I'm gonna put that one aside and then do it with this one. And then I'm gonna do these color combos. Actually, these are both red, so I'm gonna just do these colors instead because those two colors were the same thing. So I'm gonna do red. I'm gonna start with this one first. And just be careful not to pass the line, because then it'll mess up the heart. These strings together. And just squeeze it. And then I'm gonna just shoot the rest of the nails in the light color. I'm gonna wait 24, not 24 hours, 11 hours for that to soak in all the dye, and then we'll, after that we'll wash it and then dry it. So, yeah. Okay, so now that officially like all the dye has soaked in, we're gonna unwrap the rubber bands from the mask, and then we're gonna open it. Also, it doesn't matter if you messed up, I mean, you can still try again. Like, for instance, this is kind of like a dot. I mean, I haven't made the masks like a lot. So I'm still kind of learning from it. I don't know about this one. I think this one might not turn out good, but I might turn it out. I might re-dye it and turn it into something else. I feel like this one is kind of bad. So I'll probably turn it into something else. But yeah, this one I can probably put gems on it to make it look like a heart. Yeah. So then the next step is to is to rinse all the dye out until like the dye is completely out and like
the water comes out clear and not full of color. So, what is it? I'll show you. I'll like. I'm going to come back when this has officially been all rinsed out and there's no color in the water. So yeah. Okay. So now that I rinsed them, they're all like, there's no really like tie-dye in them.